Do you think Mara was in the right with her argument with Tom? Absolutely.
She can have Tom, by the way. He's really not that special.
Hi, I'm Elma, and this is Text on the Beach with Cosmopolitan UK. I got a text! Hey, Elma, so what was the best thing about being on Love Island? The best thing about being on Love Island was making all those amazing friends that I've made. Who do you wish you'd been coupled up with? I wish I'd been coupled up with Anton for longer. So, yeah, I'm happy with my selection of being coupled up with him, but just wish it was for longer. I mean, I really want Anton to stay and be happy, so if he was to find a girl and crack on with her, I wish him all the best. But if he was to come out single and he wanted to go on a date with me, here I am, hon, waiting. Which islander has the most annoying habits or was the hardest to live with? Probably myself, actually. I mean, I pick my nose, I burp and I fart, so I'm sure the islanders don't miss me too much. Yeah, do you know what? I was standing in the kitchen, it was just me and Mike, and I didn't think it was going to be a loud fart, and it was louder than expected. And he just looked at me and went, "Did you just fart?" I was like, And then I was like in hysterics, out of laughter, like where I was just so embarrassed. I was like, I can't believe that actually happened as loud as it did. But I think they just got used to me in the end, to be honest, yeah. Who do you want to win? I'd like Amber and Michael to win. I think they're the purest people separately and as a couple. So yeah, they're who I'm rooting to win. Which couples are genuine? I think Amber and Michael are 100% genuine. I think they're all genuine now, like in terms of they're all in the relationships for a reason. Everyone that's coupled up is in that couple for a reason. Minus Anton and Lucy, who are friendship couple, so they don't really count. But everyone else I think is moving in the romantic way, 100%. Who in the villa is playing a game? Oh, that's a hard question. I don't think anyone is actually playing the game as such. I think they all are in there for the right reasons in terms of everyone does seem to want to find love. So I'm going to say no one's playing a game. It's a hard one. What's Mara like in real life? Mara is exactly what you see on the telly. She's exactly the same in real life. That is Mara to a T. She is the nicest person. She's got the kindest heart and she's just fiery, but she's a good crack. She's good to go out with. She's good to have fun with. And she was a lovely person to live with in the villa. Obviously going in together, we've got that little bond. So yeah, we stayed solid together for a long time and we still are solid. So even with coming in and, you know, having drama when we first walked in with all of the girls, giving us a little bit of a frosty reception, we did well. So we did have a little bit of drama between our little love triangle, between Tom and Mara and I, but you know what, girls always stick together and it wasn't really anything, to be honest. It was just, she thought I broke girl code, I knew I didn't break girl code, so I went back and told her I didn't break girl code and she agreed. So yeah, that was that. She can have Tom, by the way. He's really not that special. Do you think Mara was in the right with her argument with Tom? Absolutely. I think women empowerment, she has gained a lot of respect from everyone and I think she deserves the respect that she's gained. Yeah, absolutely no way. You do not have a man disrespect you like that in front of all the boys, behind your back or to your face, no way. Is it true you're going back into the villa? I don't actually know where this has come from. I think if I was given the option to go back into the villa, I would love to, but I've not been told I'm going back into the villa, no. So as of now, no, I'm not going back into the villa. I think it was an open question. People were saying, I think I was in an interview and they were like, would you go back in? I was like, yeah, you one day back in. And then they're like, would you go back in? I was like, well, given the opportunity, I would. Like, our contract obviously states up until the 31st of, I think, July, or might be the 4th of August, like we're tied into the show. That's how everyone's contract is. So there is a potential, but I doubt it highly. I don't think they'd do that to us. Who should Danny have picked? You wonder, or Arabella? If he's genuinely gone with his gut, I think he's done the right thing. Because obviously, essentially, the aim of the game is to, you know, find love. And you're going to stay on the show if you love someone. So, or want to find love with someone. So I think he did the right thing in terms of if he genuinely thinks he's got that extra connection with Arabella, then 100% he should have picked Arabella. But that being said, after everything he said to you one day, I think he should have gone with you one day. Yeah, bad Danny. If you like what you saw today, subscribe to Cosmo's YouTube channel.